our presentation today about paratuberculosis in Egypt and Arab area. This is an important disease economically and zoonotically. So our aim in this discussion to discuss about the methods for control of this disease in animals and in humans. Paratuberculosis, a chronic, incurable, wasting bacterial infection of ruminant caused by Mycobacterium avium paratuberculosis, affecting primarily the intestine tract. This disease has long incubation period. The symptoms appear after 2 to 5 years from infection, discovered in 1895 by John in Germany. Mode of transmission of this disease through manure, semen, urine, milk, and colostrum. Transmission mainly by fecal oral transmission, also can be uterine transmission. Occur in calf at early age, but the clinical disease occur usually after 2 to 5 years. Infection rate of cattle with Mycobacterium paratuberculosis in Europe about 7 to 55%, in USA about 40% in examined bovine hearts, and chick 25% among cattle herds. In Australia, 9 to 22 in bovine. In Egypt, 3 to 40% in bovine. In Saudi Arabia, about 30% between the rearing men and rearing stocks. Disease picture. 95% of infected cattle show no signs. 5% only show chronic entertainment diarrhea. Clinical signs in animals more than 2 years old. Herd signs appear: one animal with chronic diarrhea, then another several months later. So the diarrhea here intermittent and on long period. This results in malabsorption, anemia, weight loss, infertility, decrease in quality and quantity of milk yield. And this is the economic importance of this disease. This is the clinical picture for natural infection in cattle. And this is the PM lesions appear as grape and corrugation in the intestinal tract with high aggregation of lymphocytic cells in the intestinal mucosa. According to Nasser et al. In 2000s, this disease described in human as Crohn's disease. This Crohn's disease described as unhealed peptic ulcer and intestinal ulcer, and the surgical interference only the way for remove this problem. The economics of this disease, losses depend on the infection rate within the herd, about $50 per cow if one or more positive cow in the herd. If one, only one cow in the herd is positive, this cost the farm $50 per herd. If 10% of culled cattle in the herd suffer from positive cases, it cost about $200 per head. Percent of cow testing positive by lactation revealed that the third and fourth lactation period is the main period suffering from this disease. The decrease in milk in infected herd ranged between 100 and 150 kilograms per 1,000 and 100,000 and 150 kilograms per season. Diagnosis of Mycobacterium paratuberculosis, either by direct stain of fecal and tissue samples, by hematological and biochemical examination, fecal and tissue culturing, and PCR examination, cytokine detection. The problem for diagnosis of this disease in the early diagnosis. We can't diagnose this disease in the early period, but only we can diagnose the disease after the clinical signs appeared, after 2 to 5 years old. And this caused the economic cost. So we try now to discuss how to diagnose this problem in early stage and make a good vaccine to control this problem. We depend on some hematological and biochemical changes in the early stage, but it is not confirmative. But it is not confirmative. For example, the in early stage, we can not no differences between the infected and later infected cases. But in case of biochemical, we can not increase in GOT and GPT and also cytokines. In minerals, we can notice a decrease in the sodium and potassium and the ferrous in the subclinical and early infection. In interferon gamma, the infection, the level increase in the early stage, and tumor necrosis alpha and interleukin 10 can be differentiate the early and the late stage of infection. Control of Mycobacterium paratuberculosis require accurate, sensitive diagnostic kits, and we try now to make labeling for a new kits for this disease in Egypt, efficient, safe vaccination, biosecurity, efficient, and supportive treatment. In vaccination is not useful in an animal already infected with the disease. Vaccination only decreases the percent of infection. So we try together to reach a method for complete diagnosis for this disease. So we tried to discuss how can you make this vaccine and how to cooperate together to make this vaccine to solve this problem. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much for this interesting talk. Have you thought about using specific bacteriophages for a therapy? So I know from Australia, against dermatophytos, you can use specific phages, and from root bacteria, there are also some phages which are very specific.
Yeah, we tried to use bacteriophage for treating of camels in Saudi Arabia, but it gave about 10 to 25% only. So we need to reach to 80%, 85%. This is the main of our target.
So, more questions, please?
Yeah.
I have a suggestion. It appears the animals would be shedding some of the bacteria in the feces. Why not try PCR? You can find good primers, and perhaps you might be able to diagnose the disease very early.
This disease is cell-mediated immunity. But we try now to make labeling with nano gold, as my colleague said before, to make good diagnosis in the early stage of the disease.
And about PCR, I also have to say that about paratuberculosis, it has intermittent shedding pattern.
Yeah.
So, for example, we can check PCR for paratuberculosis, but we cannot find it, and although animal is already infested, it has intermittent shedding pattern.
So the problem is the intermittency of the shedding of the bacteria on the run. It can excreted morning and not excreted afternoon. So what the time exactly to take the sample? This is the problem. This is the problem. I am here to go together to solve this problem. Yeah.